forests provide many benefits to communities, and many communities of the Belize Maya Forest are often dependent on these services. Community involvement in conservation is key. Communities have to be an integral part of sustainable management of forests, of protected areas, of really of any natural spaces. At the end of the day, it isn't about, you know, the wildlife and the trees. It's about what people or how people treat these spaces and how people benefit from them and the respect and stewardship that they show for those spaces.
Right now, we're in the middle of the Belize Maya Forest. The Belize Maya Forest is a 236,000-acre property that was recently acquired through partnership with the Nature Conservancy. This specific spot is in the middle of my Liana removal experiment, which forms the core of my PhD project.
Lianas are natural components of most tropical and some temperate forest ecosystems, but they can affect the growth rates and survival of trees. Denver is studying the impact of liana removal on forest health.
Lianas are woody vines, also known as structural parasites. Like this one, it uses the trees to gain access to the canopy, and whilst in the canopy, competes with the trees for light resources. On the ground, they compete with trees for nutrients and water, and so this reduces tree growth and can lead to premature death. In managed forests, removing lianas reduces a competitive effect, increasing tree growth and increasing forest health.
Climate change and other human disturbances are causing liana infestations to increase around the world. In 2023, a research paper from the Nature Conservancy, University of Florida, and other partners examined the impact of selectively removing lianas from trees to increase both the health and the climate benefits of forests.
Yep. 45.
Enough,
yep, let's do it. This project is looking at quantifying the carbon benefits of liberating select future crop trees from lianas to increase their growth. Our research found that by liberating just 5 future crop trees per hectare, we can increase global carbon sequestration by 800 million metric tons over a 30-year period. This is equivalent to removing 6 million cars from the road per year. Increased carbon sequestration, of course, helps the Belize Maya Forest, but is especially relevant in areas where sustainable harvesting is allowed as it increases timber yields.
In sustainably harvested forests, better timber production also reduces the risk that the land will be converted to non-forest land uses, which would harm biodiversity.
Here in the Belize Maya Forest, harvesting is not allowed. What we are doing here is experimenting to see how liana liberation affects the growth of the focal tree and the community of trees surrounding it. Focusing on individual trees allows us to promote this practice to small-scale landowners who might want to contribute to climate change mitigation by liberating a few trees.
The Belize Maya Forest Trust is the steward, manager, and trustee of the Belize Maya Forest. This forest was bought in December of 2020 by the Nature Conservancy and partners. Both local and international partners collaborated to get the initiative going. The Belize Maya Forest is a forest that is being saved in perpetuity or protected in perpetuity for the people and government of Belize. It's not only about only the forest and its protection and its recovery, but it's also about involvement of our communities. It's also about safeguarding the benefits that communities that are dependent on forests count on. Capacity building is a really key component to the management of forests, and this liana research project is no different. In fact, one of the things that we want to be very deliberate about at Belize Maya Forest Trust is local capacity building. Understanding forests, understanding how to manage forests, understanding why it's important to have a good relationship with those resources and protect them, how they affect your daily life and your health, for example. Those are important ways of promoting with communities that what we want to move towards are what we call sustainable livelihoods. We have several community members that have been working with Denver, and it's important for our communities to understand why we're doing what we're doing.
We look at lianas very important because they serve almost like a highway for the animals that move about in the forest. Lianas prevent the trees from maturing, so if we have a control with the amount of lianas, then we could have a healthy forest.
The Liana Project in Belize tests how removing just some of the lianas can improve the health of forests and increase tree growth. The larger trees can grow, the more carbon dioxide they can remove from the atmosphere, making this a promising natural climate solution.
So here we found our first tree. This is a large Santa Maria. Because lianas are herbivore spouters, we cut each liana twice. First, we cut down low, and then we cut up high. This double cutting prevents the liana resprouting from the stump from having an immediate trellis to reinfest the canopy of the trees. Liana cutting has been an approach that has been long practiced. By liberating trees from lianas, so removing liana burden from these trees, they can grow twice as fast. And this has been shown in many studies. But many of these studies also use a blanket approach to liana cutting, where they clear all lianas from a large area. What we're doing here is focusing on a single tree, select focal tree approach to liana cutting. This minimizes the biodiversity impacts because we can select, for instance, timber species to liberate, meaning that we don't clear all lianas from the area, and some lianas can remain to serve the benefits that they naturally serve.
The liana liberation experiment has a lot of, you know, intersection between all angles of sustainability. On the one hand, it's looking at how we can maintain the health of the forest, so there's the environmental aspect. But on the other hand, there's a really important and interesting economic component to it. We have started now a community program that is actually focused on looking at communities in the landscape being part of the conservation of this forest, but also through the stewardship of their own community forests and community spaces. The vision for this forest is really to be the benchmark for how protection is done. It's based on context, it's based on local relevance, and that will automatically mean getting communities to be part of the protection of this area, getting more Belizeans involved at the higher levels of science and management is part of the vision. And of course, saving the biodiversity and the amazing wildlife that we have in this forest for future generations of Belizeans is part of that vision.
The Liana Project in Belize shows how selective liana removal in managed forests can serve as a natural climate solution that benefits people and the planet. The authors of the paper are now working with carbon markets programs so that this climate-positive forest management strategy can soon be implemented in tropical and temperate forests around the world.